You're doing a very special thing for Peter Noble this year. On our opening night, Thursday the 14th of April, you are curating the Honeydripper's Dylan Party. Joe, what's it all about?
Why am I doing it? No, I just thought it would be, you know, I was asked to curate something, and I thought that would be a great thing to do. Bobby's played there, you know, he's written about 1,000 songs, and there's so many people that were sort of interested. Straight away, we got, you know, Tex Perkins was, you know, right up for it, Ross Wilson, Russell Morris, Kevin Borich, the Exes from Texas, you know, but all these different people, and lots more, were really interested. I think, you know, because, you know, Bob's part of everybody's language, really. And you can do something with these songs. You know, you can play them the way that you've heard them on record, or you can really sort of mess with them, which he does himself. And it makes it sort of more interesting, you know. And I think that's why he's had so many covers and so many hits with other people playing his music, you know. And I think it's a wonderful thing. He's also almost celebrating his 80th birthday. His birthday's in late May, I think. And I think it'll just be wonderful, Rusty.
Yeah.
It'll be a wonderful night.
So am I getting this? There's a cast list of some mighty people there. Going to be working alone, maybe some interesting doubles and triples up there that were, you know, collaborations coming?
Well, the whole idea is, you know, no one hogs the stage for too long. You get one or two songs, and you, we're sort of trying to work through the arrangements. If they want to use the band, they can. If they don't, they don't have to. There'll be sort of little duets. There'll be all kinds of different things. It's really up to the artists themselves, and I think that, that makes a difference, you know. So I'm not going to hog it, and I don't intend to do that. I'm in the background, and I get to sing a couple of songs, maybe sing a duet with someone. Everyone's got an opportunity to do a whole bunch of things that they want to do, you know. Like Fiona Boyce just said, Joe, I want you to play saxophone on this track. This is how I want it done. And that's kind of what I like, you know.
Yeah.
You just go, she knows exactly how she wants to do it, and she's going to put her faith in the Honeydrippers, and which is the Sorrows, plus a couple of other geezers, you know.
Yeah.
We're going to try to bring something that's really special and a nice way to, you know, help open the festival on that Thursday night. There's a lot of things on Thursday night, but, you know, hopefully, you know, people will be encouraged to sort of come and see it and come and see everything, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Joe, I mean, it really does sound spectacular. And as you say, there's all the people like Fiona Boys, all our exes living in Texas, Lisa Hunt, Emma Donovan. Yeah. Wow. I mean, you've assembled a huge cast of people. And I know it's going to take a lot of work, for which we thank you. And we look forward to seeing you for opening night of Bluesfest in just a few weeks' time.
That'll be great. I'm so looking forward to it. And it's getting close now, you know, like, when we thought about this late last year, you know, it's just in the back of your mind. Now it's in the forefront, and you know, you want to play good. You want to be really on it, and you want to give each artist that opportunity to be as fabulous as they can be.